tea or coffee, and there it comes to you completely what? Hot, cold, what? Lukewarm. And that's exactly the budget for you guys. Lukewarm, nothing. 5 on 10, neither garam na thanda. Beech mein. And of course, a lot of jargons have been used, you know, talking about 75 airports coming in, talking about stock markets. Yeah, stock markets, I have a different point of view. The stock market is the engine of growth, is the engine of economic growth. You cannot ignore it. You have to survive, you have to support it. And that's where investments will get channelized into the economy, into growth, into startups, into entrepreneurs. And those entrepreneurs have to create jobs. So what has happened this time? This time we've got a budget which completely ignores the capital market. And forget it. Ignoring is one part of it. We've got a long-term capital gain which has come on us above 1 lakh, which is being, you know, 10%. Luckily, it's not retrospective, it's as on 31st of Jan, the valuations have been taken. That's why the markets actually went into a shock and have recovered from there, closed at 11,017. The Nifty and 35,906 was the Sensex. Incidentally, the Sensex in the last 21 years, it's been like 11 times advances, 10 times declines, and this time it will be 11, 12 sort of, So, what are we looking at? You know, I don't understand why the government only wants to do lip sympathy with the corporates. As rightly said, when you make a statement in parliament and you say that you're going to do something, you have a ridiculous president somewhere in the other part of the world who is doing great guns, and the corporates are cheering him, and there the tax is going to come down from 35% to 21%. And that makes them globally competitive. And in India, you're still waking or not even waking up to the fact that trillions of dollars are going to move out of your countries and all these countries and move where? Go back there. What's going to happen? Have you ever thought about that? What could actually happen? What could happen to the employment which they were supposed to do in here? What's supposed to happen to the real estate which is being built for them here? Have you ever thought what could go wrong? But nobody seems to be bothered. Because Mera dil Bharat. So, you know, coming to that, that's one thing I would say, like, the tax exemption, what they've given this time, it was 50 crores. Pathetic. No small, medium enterprises will have a 50 crore turnover. 250 crores, pathetic. Who's going to benefit? Trust me, if I see the stock market, listed companies, maybe 1%. Maybe having a turnover less than, you know, around 200 crores or something. I doubt even that, but I give them the benefit of doubt. So what are you benefiting? So you hear, you know, it's just like this. Guy hai, oh, guy looks chubby, aur dud nikalo, bas. That's what's happening with the budget. And what are you going to do? Agreed. Yes, I agree. We do need infrastructure. We've got almost what, 5.97 lakh crores going into that. Great. We do have, you know, need for medical. 10 crore people are going to, 50 crore people are going to benefit, 10 crore families with 5 in one family. Great, because that's going to help the medical sector create jobs, employment. That's all needed. But what about the real minority? The taxpayer. What does he get? After 13 years, you bring back a standard deduction from 30,000 to 40,000, and that's what you call giving a benefit? No. The silent taxpayer of this country is the salaried person. He is a mute spectator, he gets the cake and he never gets the full cake. He gets only a cake which is already part of it is eaten. And that's how it is. So, you know, when you look at what is happening to the capital market, you said securities transaction tax we're going to put because we're not giving you long-term capital gain. Right? And now what do? Long-term capital gain we rakho, securities transaction tax we rakho. What the hell is happening? I mean, you must be joking, literally, I must say, that, you know, you can do this with, people like that. So this is something which is like a rude shock, for the corporates and for all taxpayers, actually. The reason why, of course, the finance minister thought about this is, last year, 3,67,000 crores of wealth was generated in this country. And people have claimed exemption.
So, big figure, right? 3 lakh 67, moti guy. Nikala dud. That's all is happening. But you don't understand, this is risk capital. Why do you give that exemption to capital market? You give exemption because the person is putting his hard-earned income and savings and waiting it for it to grow for a period of a year. Yes, maybe a year is less. Make it 2. If property can come down from 3 to 2, debt could have been brought from 3 to 2 and equity could have gone from 1 to 2. Great. I mean, that could have been a rationale behind it. But no, the question is tax lagao. One more thing which has of course been good in this budget has been, I think the government which has been doing good is, you know, a lot of people have become visible and a lot of people have become invisible at the same time. The people who have become visible suddenly because of GST, because of demonetization, new taxpayers have started joining in. That's good, that's great, because that makes us, you know, broaden our tax base and hopefully we don't get taxed too much in the future. And of course, the guys who went invisible, guys who completely disappeared. I have somebody's son who's a rank student and he requires more assistance and I can make him into a world-class student, but I don't concentrate on him anymore. I remove all his benefits and I give it to the other son who really requires it because he's not been doing well. So, you know, it's a catch-22 situation for the government, but politics always will favor the weak and all the favor the, you know, the masses. It's not that I'm against that, but the question is that it should be done with justification on what has been told and what has been committed in parliament. At the same time, without doing that, I think it's a complete washout. Anyway, with this budget, we've got a lot of dreams coming, especially like Govardhan has now been made into Govardhan. Yeah, biomass, great. Good, very good. At least it will prevent a little bit of smog which is happening in our, you know, in our capitals. Great, initiatives are good, everything is great, but except for the capital market which had a root shock today, and we were of course bracing for it, getting the markets were swinging wildly just a bit before that, but finally, you know, they've stayed cautious and they've closed just, you can say, almost flat. So as rightly said by our panelists here, yes, this budget has become a non-event, and I think in future most of the budgets may become non-events. And cheers to that. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.